warm storm forecast later this week, some of you may be wondering what that means for the snowpack. Right now, snow water content is near record levels in the central and southern Sierra, but heavy rain is expected and it could reach those higher elevations.
So meteorologist Heather Waldman spoke with a researcher who specializes in these rain on snow events.
One of the big challenges with forecasting this week's heavy rain is figuring out how that rain will affect the snowpack and how the snowpack will affect runoff speeds. Learning more about those interactions can give us better insights into which areas may be at greater risk for flooding and who could have extremely heavy waterlogged piles of snow on their property. Ann Hagley is currently researching how warm rainstorms like this week's interact with the Sierra snowpack. She says the most common worry that she hears about is that any spring rain could wipe out a snowpack. But that's not the case with snow as deep as it is right now.
And that is often a misconception of how the snowpack actually responds to the rain. So the majority of rain events in deep snow really actually results in an increase in the water content. And there's not really much melt to be observed in these very deep snowpacks.
And that is likely what will happen for places at and above 5,000 feet this week. The snowpack there is so deep that it will absorb that rainfall to a point. Lower elevations in the foothills will be warm enough for snow to melt as the rain falls, multiplying flood concerns in the foothills through Saturday. But in areas of deep snow, that absorbing or sponging effect is really only part of what's going on. When heavy rain falls on deep snow, it also carves out paths of least resistance to get down to the ground. Sort of like how icicles form on overhangs. Then some of that water can seep into the ground even as the snowpack keeps absorbing.
So what happens with these rain on snow events is it increases the soil moisture, it increases the base flow in our rivers, but it also increases the moisture content in the snowpack, and the snow can only hold so much.
And Hagley says that all of these factors combined can essentially prime the pump, setting up for faster rain runoff if multiple heavy rainstorms come through without significant breaks in between. So that snowpack water content, yeah, that's safe. But concerns for flooding may persist too. Back to you.